Good morning. Let's begin with our third class on module 5, that is our analog to digital circuits and precision rectifiers we had to discuss. In the previous two classes, we have spoken about digital to analog converters and two types of DACs, the weighted resistor DAC and the R2R ladder type of DAC, and we analyzed both the circuits and waveforms. We saw how it works, the expression for output voltage and all that we discussed. In today's class, let's talk about analog to digital converter. So the first part of any processing is to convert the physically available analog signals. I told you all signals in nature which are available physically are usually analog in nature. So the first step is to convert from analog to digital, and that is taken care of by the ADC. So we do the analog to digital conversion using ADC, and we do the processing in digital domain, and then we will convert it back to analog. That part we have seen, DACs we have analyzed. So in today's class, let's talk about ADCs. And among the various types of ADCs available, we have to study only one, that is the successive approximation ADC, in more detail, which is included in your syllabus. And this is one of the most commonly used type of ADC. That's why it would be ideal to study this ADC. Okay, and next, once we finish this, we'll try to analyze and design a half wave precision rectifier, and we will also try to understand the working of a full wave precision rectifier. So what is an ADC? How do I define an ADC? An electronic integrated circuit which converts a signal from continuous form to discrete form. So you have a signal like this, which is continuous in nature. If I am able to convert this signal, if I'll be able to convert this signal into, say, a binary number, something like this. So converting an analog signal into discrete or digital signal is the job of an ADC. Okay, so remember, we have understood the difference between discrete and digital. Discrete means only in the time axis it will be what? Split into definite numbers, T1, T2, T3. Whereas in the voltage axis, it can have any value. Say I can have the value 1.1, 3.5, 2.8, something. So I can have any voltages here or along the y-axis, whereas along the x-axis it is divided into definite numbers. We call this as discrete, whereas a signal which has definite values along both x and y-axis, the signal will have only values, some definite values along both x and y-axis like this. It can't take on any numbers like this, 1.1, 3.5, 2.8. I can't have any voltages. I need to have only some definite numbers along y as well as x axis. Such a signal is digital. Okay, so please get the difference between discrete and digital. Discrete is something which is discretized only along the x axis, whereas a digital signal is something which is discretized along both y as well as x axis. Okay, so if we are able to convert an analog signal to discrete or digital form, either one of these forms, discrete or digital form, it is done by an A to D converter. So it provides a link between the analog world and the digital world, like in the form of transducers. So remember, analog world, the analog signal like temperature, pressure, all those things will be sensed and converted to electrical signal using transducers, right? So transducers are those devices which will convert any other form of measured energy or measured signal into electrical signal like voltage or current. It can be a camera which converts an image, okay, to an electrical current or voltage. It stores it in the form. Today we have digital cameras which will store images in the form of binary data bits only. So we have so many different ways of doing it. Okay, so transducers are those links between the analog and digital world, and these transducers generate analog electrical voltages and currents which need to be converted to digital by using an ADC. And once it is converted to digital domain, we can do all kinds of processing using a digital computer. Any kind of processing can be done using a digital computer or a digital signal processor. Okay, so a simple the most simple block diagram of an ADC is shown here, where the analog input VA is fed to this block. This is your A to D converter or ADC. It will convert this analog input. So we considered an analog input like this. The analog signal can be anything which has a voltage varying continuously with respect to time. It will be converted into digital values like this. Okay, and these digital values are usually binary in representation, or binary representation we commonly use. We have many types of A to D converters. One is the flash type A to D converter. Remember, this gives you the fastest output. This flash ADC is one of the very commonly used A to D converters, which is used in most of the microcontrollers and all. So you have studied, and you will be studying some microcontrollers. Most of them will have an onboard flash ADC. So this flash type of converter will give us the fastest conversion. So very less time it will take to convert from analog to digital. Then we have a counter type of ADC, which makes use of an internal counter to convert, and a ramp integrating type of ADC, where it uses the principle of integration inside to convert any analog signal to digital signal. So it will integrate the analog signal over a period of time, and then it will convert that integrated voltage value to a digital value. So that's how it will be functioning. That's also one of the very useful types of ADC. And finally comes the successive approximation ADC, which is one of the most commonly used ADC. I can say ramp or integrating type is highly accurate. Okay, among others, the ramp or integrating type of ADC will give you very high accuracy, and successive approximation type is the most commonly used ADC because it is easy to implement. So it is very easy to implement and analyze. That's why they use successive approximation ADC more commonly in various applications. And we'll be studying about successive approximation ADC in our syllabus. So the question can be something like this, commonly asked. Explain the working of a successive approximation type of ADC. They can also give you a simple problem for conversion. In the earlier syllabus they would give, but maybe not for you. Okay, coming to the successive approximation ADC. Please see the block diagram of the successive approximation ADC. It consists of a digital to analog converter, which we have already studied. Any type you can use, either weighted resistor or R2R. Most commonly used is R2R digital to analog converter, R2R DAC. And we know a DAC needs a V reference, a DC voltage known as V reference, and the digital input bits are given as input to the DAC. And we have something called as a SAR or successive approximation register. SAR stands for successive approximation register. This register takes in a clock input. It also takes in an analog signal. So the analog signal is coming from here. You can see this is the analog input to the successive approximation register, and it will convert that analog signal to it will approximate, let's say it will approximate the analog signal to digital value, n-bit digital value, which is taken as output of the SAR register. D0 to Dn minus 1 represents an n-bit digital value. Okay, so the n-bit digital value will be the nearest approximation of the analog input, which is fed to the SAR. And whenever the clock is given, the SAR will continue doing the conversion. It will try to approximate the analog input to a nearest digital output value. That digital output value is fed to the DAC. DAC will again convert that digital approximation signal. SAR output, remember, is an approximate signal. It will convert that approximate digital signal back to analog. And now we compare that analog signal with the actual input signal which is given here. So the input signal V in, the analog input, actual analog input V in is fed to the comparator through a sample and hold circuit. What is the use of a sample and hold circuit? We have to a sample and hold circuit does this job. Let me show you. If this is the analog signal, the sample and hold circuit will take a sample of the signal for some time. It will hold it till the next sample comes. Now, once the next sample comes, the next sample is taken, again held for some time. Now the next sample comes, the next sample is taken, held. Okay, so next sample is taken, held at that voltage level. Next sample is taken, held at that. So this kind of job will be done by the sample and hold circuit. Why do we need to do this? Can somebody tell me why do I need to do sample and hold? I am taking a sample for a given instant of time, say t1, and I'll hold it for an instant of time t2. Why should we do that? Anybody? It's very simple. What happens if the analog value goes on changing? If the analog value is continuously changing and it is not held with the reached voltage at some level, every time I try to convert, I would have converted for some analog value, but by the time I come and compare or do something, the conversion process here involves comparison. It will take an approximation of the analog value with digital. That digital it will convert back to analog and it will compare with the input. If it is as close as possible to the input, then the conversion can stop. Otherwise, it keeps doing that till we say the number of bits or the accuracy is sufficient. So, since it involves multiple iterations through this loop, so there is a loop here and multiple iterations through that loop it should go through. If the analog value goes on changing continuously, then there will be confusion in this loop. It had initially given analog voltage as 5 volts and that was converted or approximated to a digital value, again converted to analog, something compared, so on. But by the time it is comparing, this analog value has changed from 5 to 5.1 or 5.2. then the approximate digital value will again go on changing. So we don't want that to happen. We want the analog sample to remain fixed for some time until the conversion process is completed. So you just take a sample of this analog waveform, hold it for some time. So whatever is the peak value reached here, that value will get converted to digital. Okay. Similarly, you are taking this analog sample, whatever value the analog voltage would have reached by the end of this time, that value will be held and that value gets converted to digital. That's how it happens. That's why we need to do a sample and hold operation before feeding this actual analog signal to a comparator. Okay, so that the conversion process for one value gets completed before we take in the next sample or next value. Then you have a comparator. We have already studied many types of comparator circuits. Okay, so here the input analog voltage is given to the inverting terminal of the comparator, and the feedback analog signal coming from the DAC output is given to the non-inverting terminal. So we are going to compare this DAC output to the actual input, and we are going to see the output of the comparator will be either at plus VSAT or minus VSAT. We know the comparator output can only be at positive saturation or negative saturation, depending upon when will it be at plus VSAT. Please tell me, when will the output of a comparator be at positive saturation? Yes, if I call this voltage as VA, whenever VA is greater than VIN, we are calling the analog input voltage as VIN, which is given to the inverting terminal, and this converted analog value as VA, output of the DAC, is called VA. Whenever VA, which is given to non-inverting terminal, is higher than VIN, which is given to the inverting terminal, output of this comparator will be in positive saturation. And I can consider that positive saturation as logic 1. Okay, we'll treat that positive saturation value as logic 1. Similarly, whenever VA, the voltage at the output of the DAC, which is given to the non-inverting terminal, is less than the input analog voltage, which is given to the inverting terminal through a sample and hold, whenever it gets less than that, the output will be at negative saturation, and negative saturation will be treated as logic 0. Okay, so positive saturation output of the comparator will be considered as a logic 1. Negative saturation can be considered as logic 0. And anyway, that value, that 1 or 0 is fed here. Okay, output of the comparator, let me say, instead of calling it analog input, I'll just say it is plus VSAT or minus VSAT, or logic 1 or 0. This kind of, it's like a switch or control signal. So when you give 1, there should be some change in the SAR. When you give 0, some change should happen. So this kind of control signal, which is the output of the comparator, is fed to the successive approximation register. So I hope you got to know all the terminologies here. Only one thing left, that is EOC. EOC stands for end of conversion. This is an output signal coming from the ADC. This whole, all these blocks put together is the successive approximation ADC. This end of control signal will be made high whenever the conversion is complete. Whenever the conversion becomes complete, the EOC signal will become high. Is that clear? So this is the working of successive approximation ADC. It is very simple and it will give you easy marks in the exam. You will just be asked to describe the working of the successive approximation ADC with a neat block diagram. Okay, let's try to analyze this working. I'll just explain this working once and we will do the analysis next. So whenever the input analog signal is sampled and one sample of the input analog signal, let's say Vin1, is fed to the inverting terminal, and initially this VA will be zero. There won't be any DAC output when we begin the comparison, so this will be zero. So what will happen? The voltage at the inverting terminal will be greater than voltage at the non-inverting terminal. The output of this comparator will be at minus Vsat or logic zero. So output of this will be at logic zero or minus Vsat, and that is fed to the successive approximation register. This successive approximation register will make an approximate digital output for this. It may start off with a digital output which is half the value. So if the maximum output is all ones, say I have an 8-bit successive approximation register, if the highest output is all ones, then I may bring the output to a middle value, that is one followed by all zeros. Okay, we can set this to a middle value, and then this digital value is brought to the DAC, which will convert that digital to a voltage. So if the reference voltage is 5 volts, for half the value the reference, the analog output will see the, it is a digital signal representing half of the maximum. Yes or no? So the reference voltage, if at all it is 5 volts, I will get an analog equivalent which is nearly half of this reference, nearly 2.5 volts. That will be compared with this input signal Vin1. If Vin1 is 5.1 volts or 5 volts say, this 2.5 is less than this. So again, output will be at negative saturation. Again, we will increase this in steps. I'll show you. It will go through multiple iterations till we deal with all the bits and till we complete. So we'll go on doing single bit changes in this SAR. You'll see this SAR output. First, I'll if I do the MSB bit, then I'll do the bit next to the MSB, then the third bit, then the fourth. So one by one, we will go on changing these values. Okay. So I'll show you how it is done. Just before that, we'll see the algorithm. It uses an n-bit DAC and original analog signal results. So performs binary comparison of the DAC output voltage VDAC and VIN. You can call that as VDAC or VA. We named it as VA. The output of the DAC is compared with the input analog voltage Vin, and MSB is initialized at 1 for the DAC first. As I told you, the most significant bit is made 1 and all the other bits are made 0 initially. And now in the comparator, if the input voltage is less than the DAC voltage VA, okay, then the MSB bit will be reset to 0. So if the input voltage is less than the DAC voltage, we had set this MSB bit, right? We started off by making this MSB bit as 1 because it gives us half of total value. So we it's like a binary search algorithm. You divide the complete set of data into 2 halves and you search whether it will be there in the upper half or lower half, and then you start searching individually, right? In each of the halves. This is something like that. We first bring the output to half of the total value and we'll try to see whether it is above half or below the half voltage. The given input analog, whether it is above half of the analog value generated by the DAC or below that. So once this results, that is the input voltage is less than the DAC output voltage, then it means that the input voltage is less than half the value. So I have to reset this to zero. Whatever I had made one here, I will make it zero, and then I will make the next higher bit one. So if the initial MSB bit, which was one, resulted in an analog voltage VDAC, which was what? More than VIN, which was more than the given input voltage. That means I have to reset this MSB to zero and make the next higher bit one. But if the input voltage was higher than this DAC output, so if VIN was more than the DAC output voltage, then this bit will be retained as 1 and the next bit will also be set to 1 for the next round of conversion and comparison. So next, rest all are zeros. This is passed on to the DAC. The DAC converts this digital value to the what? Some analog voltage, we call it as VA or VDAC, and this VDAC will be compared with VIN. So you have VIN and VDAC compared. VDAC is given to the non-inverting VIN. Output here will be plus VSAT or minus VSAT. So this is the algorithm used for successive approximation. So what is the step? First step is set the successive approximation register output at half the highest output value. The highest output value will be all ones. Half of that means the MSB bit will be one. Make the MSB bit one and all bits zero. Convert that to analog using the DAC and compare that DAC output voltage with the actual input voltage using a comparator. If the input voltage is less than the DAC voltage, then make that MSB bit back to zero. If it is more than, if the input voltage is more than the DAC output, then make that MSB bit high and the bit next to the MSB also high. And again convert it and compare. So this algorithm goes on repeating until we reach the least significant bit. That's what I was telling you. If it is an 8-bit DAC, it will go through 8 iterations. Only then we reach the least significant. So every bit should be set and if needed, reset. So bit by bit, we need to set it first, convert it to analog, compare it with the input, and depending upon the output, you either reset it or continue keeping it high and make the next bit high. That's how we proceed through the algorithm. At the end, the DAC input voltage will become almost equal to the output of the ADC. So we know that whatever digital bits here, these bits are the actual output bits of the ADC. So this would be the analog to digital converted output. Okay, whatever input bits we are taking, they will be the final outputs of the ADC after completing n cycles. After n clock cycles are completed, for each clock cycle, one bit will be made high, converted, compared, and again we will take care whether it should remain high or it should be made zero, and the next successive bit will be made high in the next clock cycle. So for each clock cycle, if I make one bit high, for an n bit ADC, I'll need n comparison clock cycles. So it will go through that loop n times, and we need n clock cycles to finish conversion. Okay, and after n clock cycles, whatever are the digital values here, which will be considered as the inputs to the DAC, or outputs of the successive approximation register. They will be the final outputs of the ADC. Okay. So this is the algorithm. Do you have any doubts with the algorithm? Yes or no? If you have understood, please message at least on the chat or at least unmute and reply. So operation of the successive approximation ADC, as I told you, the successive approximation register is the heart of the converter, and the output of that successive approximation register will be converted, connected to the 8-bit DAC. Output of the DAC VA is then compared with an analog input voltage using a comparator. Output of the comparator is serially connected to the successive approximation register again, and the SAR adjusts its digital output according to the analog input VIN, and 8-bit latch will hold the digital data at the end of the conversion. So as I was telling you, the digital data is available here. If you use a latch here, that latch will contain the digital data at the end of the conversion, which can be taken out as required. So this is the description. You can take an example here. Okay, consider an example where we start off with an 8-bit DAC. So what do we do? This is the actual digital representation, which equates some analog voltage, 5.1 volt or something. Okay, the corresponding value. Now, how do we start off with the approximation in the successive approximation register? The first thing to be done in the successive approximation register, according to the algorithm, is make the MSB bit high. Once you make the MSB bit high, okay, you convert this to analog value. So you convert it to analog value and compare it with the input voltage in the comparator. So in the comparator, you will be comparing the analog value, which is DAC output, with the actual input signal Vin. Though I use a sample and hold circuit, I need not show it explicitly, it's understood. And the output here, say for example, the output of the comparator is plus VSAT or logic 1. If the output of the comparator is logic 1, that means this 1 is justified. The input signal is more than, so a 1 here means the input signal is more than the DAC output voltage. Vin is greater than VDAC, we get a 1 here, and that 1 will be retained. This 1 will be retained in the next round of comparison, and the next higher bit will also be made 1. We change the second bit next to the MSB from 0 to 1. And now again we convert it to an analog voltage. We compare it with the input voltage. Now what is happening? You see, the output of this comparator has become 0. 0 means something minus VSAT. This means Vin is less than VDAC in this case. The input voltage is less than VDAC if we made both these bits high. So what should I do? I give a feedback to the successive approximation register. I go back and reset this bit. The second bit is reset, and now the third bit will be made 1. Okay. So the third bit is made 1. It is converted to analog in the DAC, and it is compared with the input voltage. When it is compared with the input voltage, if the input voltage is more than the output of the DAC, the output of this comparator will be 1. And when this is a 1, the successive approximation register retains the value. It will retain this third bit as 1. And in the next cycle, it's going to make the fourth bit as high. and that process is repeated. As you can see, what is happening now? Again, when the fourth bit is made high, the output of the comparator is 1, which means again the input voltage is still greater than the DAC output voltage. So retain this 1, don't change that. And the next bit should be made 1 for the next cycle. Next clock cycle, you make the fifth bit as 1. So now this whole value will be converted to an analog voltage. It will be compared with the input voltage. And when it is compared with the input voltage, we are getting a 0, which means now the input voltage is less than the DAC output voltage. So I have to reset that bit. If I get a 0, I have to make this bit which I had made 1 should again be reset and made 0. As you can see, the fifth bit is made 0. Now the sixth bit is set. Repeat the process. Again, you are getting the comparison voltage as a 0, the comparison level, which means what should I do? The sixth bit should also be reset. For the next cycle, the sixth bit should also be reset. The seventh bit should be set. So you set the, this is a high, sorry, while copying down, made a mistake. And when you set the seventh bit, again, convert to analog, compare it in the comparator with the input. Now the output has shown a 1, which means the input is now greater than the DAC voltage. So the input is greater than DAC means you retain this as a 1 in the next cycle and just make the LSB bit 1. Now we have come to the least significant bit. Make that as high, do the conversion and compare the converted voltage to this. You are getting a 0, which tells we have to reset it. But since we have completed all the, all the 8 bits, we'll just go back and in the end, I will just reset this LSB bit to 0. So the output, what we are going to see will be something like this. 10110010. This will be the final digital converted output, which will be stored on a latch. And I won't repeat the cycle after this because I am done with all the 8 bits in my successive approximation register. If I have a 10 bit or 12 bit ADC, I'll repeat till I come to the LSB bit. Start with the MSB by setting the MSB and go through the loop. Okay, I hope this is clear to you, the working of the successive approximation ADC. Please ask if you have any doubts. The same thing is shown here. We have the successive approximation register and all that. You see, as you can see here.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, while comparing, what did we take as a reference voltage of the comparator, ma'am?
The reference voltage will normally be 5 volts. Most of the times, the reference voltage can be taken as 5 volts. But again, it can vary depending upon the design of the ADC. Different manufacturers will specify different reference voltages. See, here I'm showing you another example of a 5-bit ADC. The second example, please see. Vin is 0.6 volts and the reference voltage here is 1 volt. And we need to design a 5-bit A to D converter. So we are showing for each bit, whenever that particular bit is high, what would be the actual output voltage? If the final output voltage should be equal to Vref, if the most significant bit, this is your most significant bit, if that bit is a high, it will give me half of this output voltage or the reference voltage, which is 0.5 volts. Are you following? If we use a reference voltage of 1 volt here, the output voltage of the DAC will be half of that voltage, reference voltage value, when the most significant bit is 1. So if you see in cycle 1, observe carefully here with voltages I am explaining. In 5-bit ADC, the input voltage, analog input voltage to be converted is 0.6 volts. Here it is 0.6 volts and it can be held at that level, 0.6 volts it is held. And in the first cycle, we are going to make the MSB bit in the successive approximation register as high. So the SAR value will be 1 followed with 4 zeros. Since it's a 5-bit ADC, MSB bit high followed with 4 zeros. So what will be the output of the DAC? The output of the DAC will be generally VREF divided by 2. 2 power 1 because this is the most significant bit. Remember we wrote the output equation for the DAC in the previous classes. Whenever MSB bit is high, the output of the DAC will be VREF by 2 power 1 or VREF by 2. So 1 by 2 means the output of the DAC will be 0.5 volts. Now what is happening? 0.5 volts is the output of the DAC and the input voltage is 0.6 volts, right? Vin is 0.6. So Vin is surely greater than VDAC. So what will happen? Whenever Vin is greater than VDAC, we retain this MSB bit as 1 itself. We'll not reset it to 0. We'll keep this bit as 1, telling that it is correct. The input voltage is more than this reference voltage which we have generated. So retain that value and make the next higher bit 1. See, in cycle 2 now, we have made the second bit after the MSB high and we have retained the MSB bit as 1. That was because the input voltage turned out to be higher than the DAC output voltage. Now what would be the converted voltage corresponding to these two bits being high? See, if this bit is high, it is 0.5. If bit 3 is high, if the value is 0100, the corresponding output value will be VREF by 2 square or VREF by 4. How much is 1 by 4? 1 by 4 corresponds to 0.25 volts. So when this bit is high, the value of analog voltage converted value is 0.25. When this bit was high, the output voltage analog value was 0.5. When both are high, it will be 0.5 plus 0.25 or 0.75 volts. Are you following this? So now when it is 0.75 volts, compare it. This conversion has been done by the DAC. So the DAC output voltage is 0.75 volts, whereas the input voltage was only 0.6 volts. So what happens at the output of the comparator? The output of the comparator will result in Vin being less than VDAC. So if Vin is less than VDAC, what should we do? We have to change this bit 3. Whatever we had, this bit 3 which we had set, we have to reset. See, from 1 we are changing it to 0. That is because the input voltage turned out to be less than the DAC voltage. So we have to reset this. And for cycle 3, I will make this bit as high. The third bit from the left, we'll make it high in cycle 3. So observe it. Cycle 3, the SAR third bit is made high. If the third bit is made high and the first bit is high, the corresponding analog output value generated by the DAC, it will be 0.5 plus when the third bit is high, 00100, the output, analog output would be what? Of the DAC, it will be VREF divided by 2 cubed, 1 by 8. 1 by 8 corresponds to 0.125 volts. So whenever the third bit is high, it is 0.125 volts. And whenever the first bit was high, it was 0.5. Since first and third bits are high, add both the voltages, we get 0.625. Now again compare. Input was 0.6, whereas DAC output turned out to be 0.625. So the input is still less than the DAC output. You see how close we are coming, how close Vin and VDAC voltages are now compared to what it was before. So again, it is less than this, means what should I do? The successive approximation bit 2 should be reset to 0. So again, reset bit 2 to 0. So you have a 5-bit, this bit is reset to 0. Now move on to cycle 4, where the next significant bit is made high. So this fourth bit from the left side is made high. Whenever fourth bit from the left side is made high and the MSP is also high, the total voltage will be 0.5 corresponding to this, and corresponding to this value, the analog output of the DAC would be VREF by 2 to the power of 4, 1 by 16 volts, which turns out to be 0.0625 volts, half of this. See, first, if the MSB was 1, the voltage was half of V reference, 0.5. When the bit next to MSB was 1, it will be half of this 0.5, it will be 0.25. When it is the next bit, it will be half of that, 0.125, so on. So 0.0625 would be the corresponding voltage. Add it to 0.5. So I'm getting the analog converted voltage from the DAC as 0.5625 volts. Compare the input now in the comparator. You see the input voltage is now greater than the DAC output voltage, which is just 0.5625. So what should you do? You have to keep this bit unchanged. Retain the SAR fourth bit unchanged. Leave it as 1. And now in cycle 5, we'll move on to the least significant bit, bit 5. We'll make it high. And the least significant bit, when it is high, the output of the DAC would be VREF divided by 2 to the power of 5. So it will be VREF divided by 2 to the power of 5, which will correspond to 0.03125 volts. Now you add all the voltages corresponding to 1 positions in the SAR. This corresponds to 0.5, this is 0.0625, this corresponds to 0.03125. So I'm getting a total converted analog output value of 0.59375. And now you compare Vin with VDAC. Vin is 0.6, which is still greater than 0.59375, but it is very close, you can see. So keep the least significant bit unchanged or leave it as high. So since we are done with the 5 bits, we have considered only 5 bits in the successive approximation register. Since we are done with 5 bits, the output, digital output of this example will be 10011, corresponding to analog input of 0.6 volts with a reference voltage of 1 volt. Hope you understood it much more clearly with this example. Please ask if you still have any doubts. Why a precision diode and precision rectifier is needed? Let's try to analyze the working of precision rectifiers in detail in the next class.